Welcome back to the What Evs Minicast. Be Quanchi here, and today I want to talk about the recent announcement from Square Enix about the Final Fantasy Pixel Remaster games. So they dropped a very, very short trailer during E3, and I want to talk about my thoughts, my speculations, some things I heard, and kind of dissecting a little bit as much as I can. And for me, honestly, I've been really, really wanting some sort of legacy content, whether it be ports or collections or some updates, especially on Nintendo Switch. I think ever since Switch announced the NES and SNES games collections that they have with Nintendo Switch Online, it's been that long. But this kind of feels like a monkey paw wish that, you know, we're getting what I'm wishing for, but there's a downside. So I want to start with the first two games of the series, Final Fantasy 1 and 2. So looking from the trailer, it does indeed look like they're going to have updated graphics. They seem something that we quite haven't seen before. To be honest, I really like the Game Boy Advance ports. I know Final Fantasy 1 and 2 were bundled together in some of those ports. For Game Boy Advance, I believe it was Dawn of Souls, and PlayStation, it was Origins. I really like those games. I think those do a really great job with the first two ones. But this one feels maybe not as good, just looking from little visuals we have. Especially Final Fantasy II, I feel it's kind of a black sheep of the Final Fantasy family. I know it's kind of different with its leveling system. Kind of fun to play around with some of the mechanics, but I don't see me really playing that one or going back to that one. Of course, Final Fantasy I is a very classic one, so that's kind of neat, but I'm not sure if these pixel remasters are going to really grab me. I might skip over them. So the next one is more interesting is Final Fantasy III. Because this was released for the Famicom in Japan, but we never really got a direct translation released in America. We did eventually get the game with a 3D remake that was dropped for the DS. It eventually came to Steam as well. But the original one, I know that characters is like the Onion Kid, Onion Knight, which is kind of more of my favorite characters of the series because I like how he's presented other Final Fantasy games. Mostro and the mobile games like Final Fantasy Record Keeper and Brave Exvius. So it seems like we'll have a more true translation of the original Final Fantasy III game. So out of the ones they announced, this one I might actually check out. Now after that one is Final Fantasy IV. And this is also when things get a little bit more interesting because the weird history of Final Fantasy is that some games we didn't get in order. Because Final Fantasy IV was released as Final Fantasy II for the SNES, so we didn't even get the original one, the original Final Fantasy II, until it was re-released later, like in Dawn of Souls Origins. But Final Fantasy IV, it's one of my favorites personally. It was one of my first RPG. I played it a lot. They do have a really good remake that they made on DS and eventually came to Steam. And they did make a sequel. I don't think we're going to see the sequel, the after years, in this collection. I think it had some mixed receptions. I know it was kind of like dropped in episodes. I think first on mobile, I did play the eShop for Wii ports of after years. I like it, but I don't know. It feels like one of those like sequels is just a copy of the previous game. But interesting enough, they did make a 3D remake of after years on Steam. I haven't checked that out, but it's out there, and that might be interesting to check out. And then I'm going to group the last two together, Final Fantasy V and VI. And they didn't really show us really much at all. Pretty much just like a sprite of Bartz and Terra, the protagonists from those games respectively. But all like the little tidbits of like the little screenshots of like the little moments appeared to be from Final Fantasy 1 through 4. So I'm not sure what's going to come up with those two games. Because 5 was also another interesting one because we didn't get like an actual translation of that of the original SNES version. Like they skipped that one, they brought us Final Fantasy 6, but they call it Final Fantasy 3 on SNES. But eventually like got them remade for Game Boy Advance. I really, really liked the Game Boy Advance ports. They didn't make it for mobile and Steam, and those versions are ugly. I don't recommend them. A lot of people will tell you, you know, don't play them. But I feel like it's a shame because I feel like Final Fantasy V is a really, really good one of the series. I really like the job mechanics, and I feel like that one just gets overlooked just because it wasn't brought. I feel like it could have been brought over back in the 90s, but it just got that weird release. But I really like that game, and I would strongly recommend the Game Boy Advance port. But who knows if the Pixel remaster is going to be any good. So maybe that one, maybe six, but I don't have much hope. But I'll keep an ear out or somewhat interested. And so small things I saw this pointed out, but in that trailer, it looked like one of the screenshots had like a little fast forward icon in the corner. I believe they did that for the 4 remake, the 3D one. So there's going to be some quality of life somewhere in there, and if it's not just like a smart little mechanics like fast forwarding battles or maybe like a quick save or auto save or anything like that. So you might see a little bit of that. And then the trailer did end by saying that it's coming soon, but they just mentioned on Steam and mobile, such as Google Play and Apple App Store. So I don't know why, but it doesn't seem like, at least at this time, they're going to come to any other consoles, which is a bit disappointing. Like, I really, really would like to see these on Switch, especially since the older original releases were on Nintendo, Super Nintendo. So I kind of have that nostalgia of playing them on a Nintendo system, especially with a lot of the ports too. Like 7 through 10 got a lot of love in terms of they got ports on Steam, they got ports on Switch, I believe, like PlayStation Store. I haven't followed that too much, but it seems like, especially 8, I know that was another black sheep of the series, but I feel like the games after 6 got some pretty good, at least decent ports and availability in terms of different consoles. And I did see this mention, and I believe it was mentioned on Twitter, but the games are going to be sold individually. So it's a little disappointing that it's not like a collection. I can kind of see that if they have plans for mobile, because I think a collection title might be a little big in terms of size and memory for mobile devices. It may turn off mobile customers, but I don't see why they couldn't have made a collection like for Steam, or they'd bring it to consoles. And I think at least the good news for that for me is that if I maybe just buy Final Fantasy 3, I don't have to get the other 5 games. Again, like some of them I really love, like Final Fantasy 4, but in terms of like buying or rebuying these games, I think the Final Fantasy 3 is the only one that really jumps at me, but we'll see what happens. But yeah, it does look a little disappointing. And I do think it's a shame. Like, I don't know what Square is thinking. Like, and it feels like they're gonna really mess this up, especially it feels like something that could have been easily like a good collection of good remakes. And I'm gonna use an ugly term, at least with gaming. It depends who you speak with, but the abbreviation is ROM. I like to say that stands for Rely on Magic. When you play games that are on platforms that they weren't intended for, like you can magically play old SNES or Game Boy Advance games on your computer. It's an ROM, or you rely on magic. So, not gonna say, but I feel like that happens a lot, like in terms of pirating games. Like, hey, I can't get the original game like I wanted. It's not gonna be released. It's not gonna come out. So, if I'm gonna have to download it, I'm sorry, magically play it on like my computer or something that runs, let's say, I heard this word called an emulator, I guess you can call it, but. Yeah, I feel like that happens a lot too, just because we can't get these titles the way we want them or when we play them and not available. Because, of course, not gonna sell SNES cartridges again or remake them or reproduce them. I'm sure there's thrift stores and all that, but pretty disappointed. We'll see what happens. But kind of my 2 cents and a half about the announcement and all that. But just wanted to put that out there and comment below what you think or. Any additional info or thoughts about this announcement, but we'll see what happens. But that will do it for today. So be sure to subscribe. Give me some feedback. I might do these little short tidbits, videos, podcasts like minicasts in the future. But thanks for listening, and y'all have a good day. Bye.